This is the voltmeter. This is the ammeter in terms of milliamperes. This is to vary the reverse voltage. This is the photodiode. This is the illuminating device. So first we have to measure the dark current flowing through the photodiode. So to measure this, first we have to connect the connection. So photodiode connection, plus and minus, plus is connected to this. And it is connected to this. It is in reverse bias mode, but the mention whether it is wrong here. So next, the plus is connected to the plus, and negative is connected to the negative. The plus of the voltmeter is connected to this, and negative is connected to the negative. Is connected to the negative of this. So here the diode is operating in the reverse bias mode. The amount of current we are getting in terms of microamperes. So that is the reason I am using the microamperes setup here separately. The minus is connected to the minus of this. The plus is connected to the plus. So I'm switch on the circuit now. Then I'm switch on the power supply. That one. So I'm switch on the circuit now. Once I vary the voltage, switch on the microammeter. I am reading the voltage. So once I read the voltage, I can see the current is in terms of microamperes. So I am reading the reverse voltage. 1, I got 1, 4, 3. For 1.5, 1, 4, 4. For 2, I got 1, 4, 8. For 2.5, 1, 4, 8. For 3, I got 1, 4, 8. So get the constant values. If you plot the graph within the machine and the current, the microamperes, so the dark current, you will get the stable current. So it is the dark current, but there is no light on the photodiode. So the next part of the experiment is now I illuminate the light onto the photodiode. Stop this and remove now this connection. This meter now, because once I shine the light, the amount of current is going to be greater, so that you get the milliamperes. So plus is connected to this, and negative. Negative is connected to the negative. So keep the distances minimum now. Keep the distance is a minimum mode. So this is around 3.5 centimeters, and illuminate the photodiode with the light. So I vary the voltage now. Once I vary the voltage, 0.5, my current is in terms of milliamperes. This current strength is increased. So for 0.5, well, 0.5, for 1, 15 milliamperes, for 1.5, 17.5, like this, there is an increase in the current by varying the voltage. So this is for one particular distance. Now, you can do this experiment with varying the power of the light, otherwise, with the varying the distance. I'll increase the distance by, I'm varying the distance, I repeat the same process like this. So varying the distance, the amount of light falling onto the photodiode is decreases, so the current value decreases. So like this you get the values. So similarly, I can vary the distance. I can vary the distance. Now, I do the same process. The note is getting everything, light has to fall onto the diode. That is the correction for us. We make the same distance in the same position. So, by doing the same, so once again the current is decreased compared to the previous distance. If you plot the graph between the voltage and current in the reverse bias by varying the distance, for first form d is equal to 3.5 cm, this is the variation. For d is equal to 7 cm, this is the variation. For d is equal to 10 cm, this is the variation. From this graph, you can interpret that once you vary the distance is increases, the current is decreasing. That means when the distance is less, the amount of light fall into the photodiode is more, so that the current strength is more. But the distance is increased, the amount of light fall into the photodiode decreases, so that there is a decrease in the current. This current in terms of millions, whereas in the first case,